Well, today we have kicked off our massive campaign on the show and across the station with Sightsavers, and now I have Ambassador for the charity live on the show with me. Now, I always love chatting to this lady because she's as fabulous as she is talented. She's the real Galway girl, Sheila Shoga. How are you doing, my friend? It's great to talk to you.
Oh, Alan, I love that intro. Thank you so much.
Oh, Sheila, I'm all about the introductions. It's so good having you on the show, though.
Oh, I'm delighted to be on the show. It's great.
Now, Sheila, we've so much to catch up on, but first, let's talk all things Sightsavers. Now, we're both teaming up with them, actually, for their Miss Moments campaign. You're the face of the whole thing. I'm just the face for radio, Sheila, unfortunately.
Would you go way out of that? So didn't we do the launch in Galway and Erisfair in a gorgeous sunny day?
Usually they never let me out in public. Usually I'm always the radio face, so it's great that I actually got to go in a photograph with yourself. But it's such an incredible campaign and whole cause, isn't it, Sheila?
Yeah, I love it. I think it's a few things. I think number one, it's really important because they're going to do some really important work that is required.
Yeah.
You kind of take it for granted, don't you, when your vision is good and you don't have any issue, and if there is an issue, it's dealt with. But if you're living, it's obviously geography at the end of the day, but if you're one of the many people worldwide that don't have the facilities to hand that we have and the stuff we take for granted in terms of basic health and well-being,
yeah,
and your eye health is so hugely important. When you look at how many of these visual impairments are so easily treated, but it's down to funding. And that's why the work that Sightsavers are doing is really, really important. I love this campaign because I think it's getting you thinking of how lucky we all are, really, for those of us who, I had my eyes lasered years ago, but I can still see very well. People wear glasses, but we can do stuff to fix our eyesight. For, you know, the majority of people, we can see. But if that was taken away from us, and if you were in a situation where you had a very profound visual impairment, or you were blind, what that would actually mean. When you stop to think about it, it really made me think. And I suppose being a new mammy, my baby boy just turned one last week. To think that I might never see his face, it actually made me quite upset, if I'm perfectly honest. But then it made me feel so lucky that I live where I do, and that we're so fortunate, I suppose. And I think this is brilliant because, as you mentioned, from Galway, this is Galway focused.
Exactly.
It's really unique. It's completely innovative. And what it is basically that this interactive video pod will be in the Earth Square Shopping Centre for the next 2 weeks. You can go along, and, you know, like a lot of us, you want to do something good. You want to do a good deed.
Yeah.
You don't know sometimes how to go about it. And we are now living in an age where within a few seconds, if we're not grabbed by something or we're not entertained, we move on. We're bored very, very quickly. What's great about this is you can do your good deed in a matter of seconds and move on with your life and move on with your day. But the money that you donate will actually go towards some incredible work and actually helping people living with visual impairment worldwide. So this interactive video pod will allow you to donate €2 using your credit card. So all you have to do is tap it. And you'll see some examples of what that money will mean in terms of actually, restoring people's sight and what, the knock-on effect that'll have in their lives. And it's really amazing. It's really powerful. So I think it's good for a number of reasons. People feel great about it. You don't have to break the bank. €2. It's not much. It's fun. It's a very clever way of doing it. And this video pod is a brand new thing as well. And it's only in Galway at the moment, which is fantastic.
Oh, it's absolutely brilliant, Sheila. I was down there myself earlier on today. It is just incredible. We have to get all the people of Galway to get out and, of course, to donate. And all the presenters even here at Galway Bay FM, they're going to be sharing their Miss Moments over the next couple of weeks on their different shows.
Brilliant.
If they hadn't their eyesight. And I know you mentioned, of course, your little son Cahill there, but what would your biggest Miss Moment be? I'm sure it involves him.
Yeah, that's definitely, Alan, without a doubt. Yeah. I mean, you know, I suppose pre being a mammy, I would say numerous other things, but it's amazing how your perspective and your focus completely shifts when you become a parent. So for me, you know, as much as I don't have an aversion to looking at myself in the mirror, I think not seeing his face, well, I'd normally look in the mirror and picking out the bits I don't like, but anyway, but not seeing his face, that would just, I couldn't even begin to imagine
it.
I would just be a nightmare. So, you know, when you think about it in that way, and that's not being dramatic, that's a fact for a lot of people, you know,
in the world
who are living with visual impairments. So 250,000 people in the world are in the poorest countries are living with some sort of eye condition or visual impairment, and this is what this charity is doing, you know, by the generosity of the public and collecting the funds. You know, they can help restore the eyesight people. So yeah, it's great.
And Sheila, no matter what a person's Miss Moment is, even if it is just looking at themselves in the mirror or taking a selfie of themselves, as shallow as it may sound, they can still donate. And Galway is actually the second highest county in the whole country for donating. So Galway people are great for getting behind causes like this anyway.
Isn't that brilliant?
Yeah.
Oh, I love it. I love to hear that. And that doesn't surprise me at all. You know, look, we're just going to be telling each other how great we are, but it's true. Like, I'm so proud to be from Galway. And I get home a lot. I live in Dublin, but I get home an awful lot because my family and my closest friends are still there. And it's great. And you know what? I love hearing from other people who, you know, visit Galway or go down and go, God, what a great spot. People are brilliant. So laid back. People are really warm. And that's reflected. I mean, you've just mentioned the figures there. I wasn't even aware of that.
Yeah.
So that, how fantastic is that? Yeah, Galway people are great. Yeah, and 2 weeks. So if you feel like, oh, that's a great idea, I'd love to do it. It's not like it's only going to be there for a day or two. You have 2 weeks to get yourself into the Air Square shopping centre and tap your card, €2. Off you go for the rest of your day and you'll feel great about yourself.
Absolutely. Now, Sheila, as well, you've had a mad busy year because your awesome little dude, Cahali, turned one last week. It must have been the biggest whirlwind year of your life.
Totally. Oh, my goodness. I people kind of warn you of it and try and set you up first and give you loads of advice, but I don't think until you experience it, you can't quite put into words what it's about. But I do feel, and I've spoken to some friends of mine about this, it's like you almost rewire.
Yeah.
Part of your brain that kind of changes when you become a mother or a dad. You know, I think when you become a parent, it's everything shifts. Your priorities change. Your perspective and life changes. I've always been pretty emotional, but I'm probably 20 times more emotional since becoming a mother and sensitive to everything.
Yeah.
I just feel very lucky. Look, he's healthy. He's a happy little fella. Other when he's teething and he's in the wards with it, but he's a great little guy. We're having such a laugh with him. He's at a great age now where, you know, he's trying to talk all the time and it's full of reactions and laughing and he's gas, you know, and the time has just already gone by so quickly. It's hard to see the baby kind of go and him turn
yeah,
into a
yeah.
toddler. I'm like, please slow down, you know, but it's magic.
And Sheila, now you're super humble, so you're not going to admit to this, but you have become such a mumspiration to so many people. I love your Instagram posts. I have no kids and I'm clearly not a mum or a dad, but I love your Instagram page. Do you realise what a help you've been to so many mothers?
Ah, Alan, that's so lovely. And yeah, you're right. I'm kind of getting even uncomfortable with you saying that, but I know, if people are getting something from what I'm posting, I'm delighted to hear that. I definitely know from talking to people, and I'd be the same myself. I think when you see someone kind of just being honest, it's refreshing. And luckily, there seems to be a nice change happening in the world of social. I think the sites or the pages and the people that we like to follow tend to be the ones that kind of say it as it is.
Absolutely.
I think when it started initially, there might have been a bit more of that, let's portray perfection. Now, I'm not saying that I you know, it's still only a side of you, isn't it, on the likes of Instagram or Twitter or whatever.
Yeah,
it's
totally.
Not your entire life. It's
no.
Elements of you. And, you know, it'd be unfair of me to say that, oh, that's the way I am every day, because I normally, to be fair, I rarely go on without a screed of makeup. So there is an element of vanity there.
Yeah,
I'll always
have
a bit of concealer or a bit of mascara on or a bit of something. So, you know, I don't tend to do it just as I've woken up before I have the morning coffee. So, you know, there's real and then there's, you know, you could be authentic but still have the bit of makeup on, which I love. But no, I do. I love it. And it's nice to get messages from not just mammies, but women or even fellas when, you know, they're saying, God, thanks for saying that. Or it's great to hear that. And we're all the same. We're all trying to learn. I mean, I think, and I've spoken to some friends of mine with kids, you're kind of just chancing your arm every day as a new mum.
Yeah, yeah.
You can read all the books. Yeah, you can do all that kind of stuff. But it's not until you experience it that you actually learn. So some days you get it right. Other days you don't. Like, I only realized a few weeks back that I should have been brushing his teeth. I felt like the world's worst mother. But I'm thinking, geez, he's only a baby. Why would he be cleaning his teeth? But apparently, as soon as the first tooth arrives, they should be brushing their
teeth. Really? God, that's mad. Never do
so
that.
So I'm a really bad mother. He's had his first tooth since he's only a few months in. The poor fella. He might need a load of fillings now because, I don't know. But
I love your honesty, Sheila. If you're not following Sheila Shoga on Instagram, Do it right now. And tomorrow you're going to post the second you wake up, not a slap of makeup on your face. You have to do it now after coming on the show. Just maybe get out of the bed, the hair all tossed, and go live on Instagram.
I'll tag you, as especially for Alan.
Absolutely. But commercially, you mentioned, of course, everyone can donate at the Sightsavers Depot. That's in the Air Square Shopping Centre. There's also another really, really easy way they can donate as well. You can just text GBFM to 50300. You can do it right now. Come on, pick up your phone to do it. €2 goes to Sightsavers, well, at least a minimum of 180. Sheila, we love having you on the show. The next time you have to come into studio to me, definitely.
I'd love it. Yeah, big time. Big time, big time. I have to go into you.
You're absolutely fab in every single way, Sheila. Thanks so much. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks so much, Alan.
Bye.
Bye, bye-bye.